Hello, beautiful people. I'm Dimi and tech is my passion. I suspect tech is your passion too, since you are on this amazing channel. Of course, you clicked on this video because you want to change your DNS servers on your Android TV device, whether it is a Fire TV stick or a Mi Box S or a TV stick with Android TV or a TV box, normal TV box, or the Nvidia Shield TV as I have right now. And I'm going to demonstrate it to you. You can change it easily and with not that much hassle. Let's go into the device to see how we can do that first of all. And just a reminder before we continue, hit that like awesome button if I helped you, and in order to help also with the algorithm of YouTube. And if you did not subscribe yet, now it's the time to do it. Of course, it's absolutely free. You get the best possible content. Now, here we are inside my device. Let me grab my remote. This is the Nvidia Shield TV. Now my menu, my home screen may be different, but you got the idea. And this way, this method works also on any Android TV television. I mean, if you have a TV that comes with Android TV OS, operating system, this is how you can do it on every single TV. Of course, if you want to proceed, I have to mention, since I saw it, the easiest by far method to change your DNS is by having a VPN. And by the way, Ivacy, which is the one I personally use, is now on an offer. If you want to grab it for, I think, $1.10 a month, grab it from the link down below in the description. It's super easy. You simply open it and you can simply change among countries or channel, vast selection, huge selection of countries, and of course also channels if you want to go directly into, I don't know, Netflix US, HBO Now, Max, Fox, CBS, Spotify, and all that goodies. Amazing value for money. But for you hardcore people that want to change the DNS server by yourselves, just do it. Follow me. We are gonna need, I'm gonna show you also how you can grab another free application in order to help us with some of the things that we need to change. And in order to do so, you need to go into the Google Play Store or in your apps library if you have a different layout than me. If you go on the top and select apps or enter inside the Google Play Store, here we are, we simply go and do a search. We need a free app that it's also very helpful because you can do also speed test and stuff like that. It's called Anality. So let's begin by typing it. Now I made a joke on my Greek channel when I've searched for this application, which I'm not gonna do on the on this one. Anyways, speed test Wi-Fi analyzer Anality. Let's select it, and where mine says open, over here, yours should say install if you haven't have it already. Once you got it, simply I need you to open the application. Why we need to open the application? Of course, you can do a speed test as I've mentioned, but that's not the important thing we want to do. We need to select from our remote the left button and select where it says check VPN. Now, why do I do that? Because we need to write down a number, which is the number we see, gateway IP. Simply write it down. Now in my case it's 192.168.31.1. in yours may vary, almost surely will vary, because I have plenty of routers connected inside my lab. So write down this number, it's very important. Once you have written it down with just remember, this is the gateway IP. Please write down also that. We're gonna go back and we go into the settings. And now we select the connection we have. Whether we have Wi-Fi or Ethernet, that's not important. Simply select it. And once again, select your connection. You will find your IP address. That's the IP address of the device you are currently using. So in my occasion, it's 192.168.31.1. 31.60, you should also write down this IP address. Once you have done that as well, go where it says IP settings, always from the same menu, and we're gonna change it from DHCP into a static IP. Now, enter the IP address that you've written down just before. That's the IP address of your device. In my occasion, it's 192.168.31.60. In yours, it should be surely different. So, once you have written it down, continue, hit on next, and now we need to add the gateway. As you remember, we downloaded the application Analytics just for this number, because there are also different ways that you can find the gateway IP, but this is the easiest, in my opinion, for everybody. Some people are noobs, some people are more expert, some are way expert than me, perhaps, which I don't think, I'm just kidding. In any case, this is the easiest way, in my opinion. Enter the IP inside the box. So we have 192.168. Your numbers, which will be totally different. Almost for sure the last digit will be 1, but in any case. And once you have done that as well, hit on next. Do not change anything here. Leave it as is, 24, or whatever it is. And now we simply enter our DNS, our preferred DNS. 1.1.1.1 is the Cloudflare DNS. You can also change it into Google DNS. Those are the two best, let's say, and faster DNSs that you can find. 8.8.8.8 and for Google DNS. In my case, I have tested them both. Cloudflare works better. This is the DNS number. I will have the numbers also down below in the description, so make sure to read it, of course, also in the description if you need the numbers. And you can change among the two. One important thing though, if you're gonna go with Cloudflare, that's the one with the ones, stick to it also for the DNS2. That's the second DNS. So also here we're gonna enter the Cloudflare, all the Google DNS servers. In this occasion, the server is 1.0.0.1. That's for Cloudflare. On the other hand, if you're gonna try the Google DNS servers, the DNS2 is 8.8.4.4. Once finished, click on Next and save successfully. Now, if for any reason you did a mistake, chances are that your connection will not work. That means that you will not have internet. Sorry. So you are not going to be able to go through any of your devices. But just for an example here, since I have changed it, I'm going to try Netflix to see if it's working. And even though my cable is acting really strange today, let's check it out. Boom shakalaka, baby. Here we are. Let's select my profile. All right, baby. As you can see, working perfectly. Let's select something just to see that. Okay, no copyright, please. Just a demonstration and also free publicity for Netflix. YouTube we should work the same. Amazon Prime, if you have an IPTV, and all your other applications as well. If for any reason you got an issue, you got something, I don't know, you don't want to use it anymore, or you have messed up the settings, it's very, very simple how to resolve it. Go once again into settings, select your network and internet tab, then select your connection, the metrology in this occasion. We are gonna go once again into IP settings and we can change it back to DHCP. Now it will get everything in automatic. The connection should be working perfectly. And we can try again if we want to change the DNS settings, this time without messing things up. Really, really simple tutorial. One thing I have to mention though is that because your router assigns an IP number on your device, in this occasion, for example, on my Shield, every time I restart the Shield or the router, it's very possible that I will have a different IP address. So it's the best way you go inside settings, networks, if you have any issues with the connection, and change your IP, check it out, of course. First of all, go and change it into DHCP once again, so you will get everything automatic. Then check out the IP address, and if you want to change it into static once again, so you can add manually your DNS servers, enter the new IP address that is given to your device from the router. We can also assign a static, that means always the same IP address from our router to our device, but this is something different, not more advanced, it's also the same way, let's say, of difficulty, the same level of difficulty, but I don't have a router now to show it to you because every router is different. I have plenty of routers, but I don't know what's your occasion. If you want me, I can also do a video on that, how we can assign a static IP, that's always the same IP address, on a certain device on our network. That's it, guys, for today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button, as I've mentioned below. If you didn't like it, on the other hand, you can always dislike this video, but make sure to subscribe on this amazing channel. As you can see, I'm offering always the best of the best. You can follow me on all the social media platforms. I'm on Reddit, on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, Dimitrology. Tech is my passion. We have our website, dimitrology.com, and of course, we will catch up, as always, on the upcoming video. Thank you for watching.